If you guys remember from Harry Potter, there's this scene in, I think, the second or third movie with these small plant monsters that do nothing but shriek all day. To me, the mandrakes are the perfect metaphor for anxiety. Loud, obnoxious, and very, very difficult to ignore once it starts having at it.
Oh my god, I'm gonna cry!
And I know that I'm not the only one that has to confront this fucker on a daily basis. After all, statistics now show that about 1/3 of people actually struggle with anxiety on a regular basis, and things do not seem to be improving.
No, ma'am.
In fact, if I had a nickel for every time one of my students came to me asking for advice on how to manage their anxiety,
I'd have 2 nickels, which isn't a lot, but it's weird that it happened twice, right?
Regardless, every time I am asked this question, my answer is always the same. Start taking a selfie each and every day. And that's it. That's how you beat anxiety. Thanks for coming. I'm Alex. I'm a microeconomics researcher at the University of Cambridge. And in the next 2 to 3 minutes, I want to explain why taking a selfie each and every day is one of the best things you can do if, like me, you're struggling with anxiety and low self-esteem on a regular basis.
Let me tell you something!
Now, a big problem when talking about anxiety is that anxiety is kind of giving Mystique from X-Men, in that what people mean when they talk about anxiety can vary wildly from place to place. So to make things very clear, I'm going to give you my definition of anxiety, which, luckily enough, is also the objective one.
There's nothing wrong with my views or beliefs because I have freedom of speech and everything I'm saying is true.
Anyway, drumroll please. As a microeconomist, I see anxiety at its core as a faulty learning process which predisposes us to catastrophizing. I like big words and I cannot lie. I'd rather die. And let me give you a few examples. Say you're a student and you like fail one of your exams. If you're anxious, you're going to see this as a sign that you're a big dumb failure, and no matter how hard you try, you're never going to amount to anything in your life. Or say that you have an interview which for one reason or another doesn't go very well. If you're anxious, this of course means that you're unlikable and unemployable and will likely spend the rest of your life homeless, living under a bridge.
You wanna know what? No, I am gonna leave.
Or say you go on a date that doesn't go very well. Well, guess it's time to say goodbye to human contact forever and ever. Yes, it's a lot. But now you get the idea. The big problem with anxious thinking is that it has us blow each and every little thing that happens to us completely out of proportion. Quickly to the Batmobile as we're about to do some science. Last year, a paper was actually published in a top scientific journal titled Fragile Self-Esteem. I'll spare you most of the details because it has stuff like this in it.
Oh my god, what is that? Oh my god, what is that?
But the basic idea is simple. When you're anxious and have like low self-esteem, you're only going to remember the bad things you went through. See why I'm saying that if you're anxious, your learning process is going to be broken. Because if you're only going to remember the bad stuff, you're of course going to be too afraid to make changes, take risks, pursue the projects that you want to pursue.
Oh my god, what is that?
Dr. Octagonopus! Ah!
Why? Simply because you anxiously convince yourself that everything you do is going to end in failure. And this is where selfies come into play. More specifically, what you want to do is to take a selfie or a picture every time something in your life goes well, every time you have a positive experience. Because then, when you have one of your anxious episodes, when your brain is screaming at the top of its lungs that things are not going to be okay, you can essentially shove down its throat this stack of reminders of the good times.
Coochie coochie coo.
What the hell we gonna do now?
Thus short-circuiting the basic problem of anxiety of us biasly remember only the bad times.
Assaults us, leaves us in a tear.